should not panic in the case of Ebola. This world has been hit many times by many events. Ebola is certainly one of them, and we've managed to survive most of it, all of them actually. And so we will also survive this one, and we must just prepare ourselves as good as well as possible. Our chosen hospital or hospital for the treatment of an Ebola case is Tygerberg, and this is the isolation unit that we have here. And we've got specialists and super specialists here on my flanks to inform you on the medical and the scientific significance and information about the disease.
This is a viral pneumatic fever ward that has been in place since the 1990s, specifically built for possible Congo fever cases that we see from time to time. The current approach is to support the bodily functions. People have severe diarrhea, etc., so we need to kind of rehydrate them. They are very prone to get what we call a super infection, a bacterial infection, so we give them antibiotics. And we manage other system failures. If they've got respiratory failure or renal failure, we can try and manage that as well.
The National Health Laboratory Service, along with the NICD, in conjunction with our specialists in Cape Town, have agreed on a standardized approach to what the PPE should be. And there you can see pictures of it, the oval suits, the outer gloves, inner gloves, etc., with the mask. And that stuff, particularly with the guys that are going to be on the front line dealing with patients in the pre-hospital and I'm sure in the hospital environment in the units that Dr. Tyler are talking to, would don this equipment. The biggest risk, interestingly enough, is not putting the equipment on, it's taking the equipment off. And internationally, now we've developed a buddy system where we have one person in PPE that just watches the other person get dressed and watches the other person take their clothing off. So literally a step process on how we do that, and that's the type of training that we're doing.
We currently have 26 nursing staff out of the various specialities, including adults and pediatrics, because we don't know what patient we will deal with in the future, and that is excluding the doctors.
If there is a situation arise unlikely, that we think we can like situation that are more than four patients, we do have a contingency plan in that we have another facility, which is also an isolation ward for infectious diseases, where we actually manage complex TB cases, and that ward will even be a backup ward in case there are more than four patients that we need to accommodate at the time. And that ward is fully equipped with all the negative pressure and all of the isolation facilities that's required. So the four-bed isolation unit, fully equipped with all the PPE equipment that's available, and we've got all standard operating procedures in terms of how that ward, how a patient enters the ward, and how a patient gets managed within the ward.
I have a National Health Council on Thursday and Friday in Pretoria under the chairmanship of Dr. Mutswaledi. I think the most important thing we as the Department of Health can do now from the Western Cape is to give our full support to him and to the national government in preparing our country for this virus.